southwestern China, Guizhou. Amongst tall mountains and vast rivers is a land once isolated. For millennia, her hard-working people have lived in harmony with nature. Heaven and humankind as one. With their tenacity, unity, and courage, they have forged a unique culture. Today, guided by ancient wisdom, the people of Guizhou are on a quest of exploration and breakthroughs that will reshape the world. This is Guizhou, the rising star of China. Guizhou, the only province in China without a prairie. 92.5% of its area is mountainous. Yet sustainable development has made Guizhou an economic powerhouse. How have its people done it? By living as one with nature. Tongjia County, in southeastern Guizhou. At 1,000 meters above sea level and spanning over 40 square kilometers, this is one of the world's most spectacular agricultural landscapes. Terraced paddy fields. Wang Xiaolu is on his way to the rice terrace to weed his crops. With his abled assistance, ducks. This farming method is known as the rice fish duck symbiotic system. Passed down from generation to generation over thousands of years. It's a technique born out of its environment. This eco-friendly system helps farmers yield high-quality crops without the need for pesticides and fertilizers. Harnessing nature responsibly has always been part of Guizhou's people's DNA. And this practice has reaped ample rewards. The principle of living in harmony with nature applies to everything in Guizhou. From their grandest plans to the minute details, even to their cuisine. Southeastern Guizhou, the Xijiang Miao village. Popular tourist destination nestled in the mountains. People from all over the world flock to admire its beauty and to sample the local delicacies. Hu Yangxiang is a master chef here. This evening, he is preparing a specialty, sour fish soup. A rainy and humid climate can turn food bad and can also turn it into something delicious, such as fermented rice soup. It's tart, yet refreshing. A unique flavor resulting from fermenting rice soup and water. The people of Guizhou applied this unique formula and created this delicacy, sour fish soup.
我们的烧汤鱼里面也放了很多一些中药材, 比如像野生的木姜子,
And there's one ingredient this dish cannot do without. Chili pepper. The spice is a staple in Guizhou cuisine. It is unclear how chili pepper first came to China, but historical records show that they have been used in Guizhou cuisine for over 400 years. Helping to create the unique Guizhou flavor. The people of Guizhou also believe that chili can help expel dampness and warm the body. Today, chili has become an integral part of Guizhou's cuisine, with even more interesting ways to use it. Spring festival is nearing. Wang Binrong is preparing two different chili sauces. For the first, she fries the chili peppers in hot oil. Then she grinds them into a powder. For the other sauce, chopped chili flakes are fermented in a process similar to make the sour soup. Guizhou's chili recipes have stepped out of home kitchens and onto the international market. The most popular Lao Gan Ma sauce is now sold in Europe and America. At a distillery on the banks of the Guizhou River, Guizhou's most famous export is undergoing fermentation. This is where nature has given Guizhou its one-of-a-kind advantage. Over 18,000 types of microorganisms, silently working their magic at a carefully controlled heat of 63 degrees Celsius, turning local sorghum into an alcohol with a distinctive scent and an exquisite taste. This is the renowned Maotai, China's most famous spirit. In recent years, its popularity has soared both in China and overseas. Sour fish soup, Lao Gan Ma, and Maotai. They are the results of harnessing nature's gifts in a sustainable way. And this ancient wisdom has created a unique way of life on this land. Southwestern Guizhou, Huan Fengling. Famed for its towering forests in one of China's largest areas of karst landscape. This 2,000 square kilometers of wilderness is a treasure trove of medicinal plants. Huan Fengling has attracted many explorers. An outdoors woman, Ding Ding, is one of them.
Hello, Zhong Yisan, ni hao.
Hey, ni hao, ni hao, ni hao.
Today, Ding Ding is taking Dr. Zhang Jing into the forest to search for plants. Plants plants such as jujubes, lingzhi, Chinese gold thread, and cinnamon are widely found here. Guizhou is the third largest medicinal plant producer in China. Trained in Western medicine, Dr. Zhang actually grew up in an ethnic Buyi family practicing traditional medicine.
Humans
cannot survive without nature. The people of Guizhou believe that everything is connected, and nature provides effective cures for illnesses. Like Ding Ding and Dr. Zhang, Wu Dafen from the Buyi ethnic group also relies on nature. Wu makes dyes from wild plants using a 1,000-year-old recipe.
应该是在五六岁的时候就开始学习染布了，是跟我奶奶、爷爷一起学的。
Once she's gathered the plants, Wu starts to make the dye. It's a complex and laborious process.
我们用了食用碱，还要加白酒，还要加21种中草药，就是我们要看一下染料的比例，就用碗尝一下，这个就是中草药。
The dye is now ready. Wu starts to hand draw patterns on a piece of white fabric using the wax dye. Without any visual reference, she draws inspirations from Guizhou's natural landscape. Guizhou's magnificent landscape can be beautiful yet intimidating. To Dr. Zhang, the mountains pose a formidable threat.
在探亲的过程当中呢，就了解到当地的这个医疗条件嘛，就是很差，很多好的医生哈，他都是在往县里边或者呢就是往州里边去了。当时村里边呢就有很多的老百姓啊生了病过后哈，特别是像妇科这方面的，他就没有这种女的医生。
Access to healthcare is an issue faced by countries all over the world. But in mountainous Guizhou, the problem is even more pronounced. So its people found the solution in big data. This cutting-edge technology mines and analyzes information with supercomputers to help city planners make better decisions. While much of the work is done online, physical servers are still needed to generate and store data.
超大型的数据中心成为一种新型但是又非常必要的关键信息基础设施。而它的选择呢，首先要去选择电力资源非常丰富、天气比较凉爽、而地质结构稳定、没有地震的地方。在中国西南地区，最符合这些地方的就是贵州。
In the last 5 years, close to 10,000 companies, including multinational corporations such as Apple, Dell, and Tencent, have set up shop in Guizhou, making this province one of the leading big data hubs in the world. Big data has transformed public health care. Now, across Guizhou, patients' data can be shared and analyzed securely. When needed, patients are matched with specialists in real time. And through telemedicine, healthcare is no longer impeded by the mountains.
We can talk with some of the big hospitals, doctors, and our local hospitals, the state of Guiyang Medical
College, and we can
work together to help these doctors and people to treat people.
Data is not just a industry, it is also a consciousness.
New technology brings along new opportunities, overcoming challenges posed by the mountainous landscape. The people of Guizhou have rewritten their fate and changed their destiny. Huangbochu Waterfall, the largest in China and a world-renowned natural wonder. For generations, the Bui people have lived and thrived in this nature reserve. Their village is built of stones carved out of surrounding mountains. This unique architectural style is still practiced today, evident in the Anlong National Outdoor Sports Center, built on the face of a cliff 165 meters above ground level. Hui is the architect behind this man-made marvel.
Anlong Huai Yundong 的示范公园，我们做了两个建筑，一个建筑是游客中心，一个建筑是我们称之为熔岩美术馆，也就是这个在悬崖上的美术馆。那么这个小山很有魅力的是，上面有很多非常漂亮的石头，我觉得这些石头是安龙或者说整个黔西南贵州黔西南最好的东西，非常漂亮的石头，我们希望能尽可能的保留住这个原来的地形地貌。
To create this masterpiece, he drew on ancient wisdom.
那么建筑是被分解开以后插入到小山中间，尽量不破坏石头。石头和建筑会融在一体，可以从这个角度看得很清楚。建筑尽可能的低调，但是又存在，那么它会和整个环境融在一起，变成大自然中的一部分。
Hui's inspiration for the museum came through his numerous treks in the mountains.
好，
让我们体验一次神奇之旅吧。一段难忘的旅程啊，用身体去体会大自然的美和伟大。有的时候就感觉这个爬的过程就像在做设计，也是一些发现的过程。
Working with nature instead of against it, he designed the museum to fit the contours of the cliffs, integrating various building materials seamlessly with nature.
建筑必须的所有的受力是垂直向下，那么它不是给这个原生态的环境减分，而是给自然加分。它的魅力我觉得在一个淳朴的逻辑，比如说它就地取材，利用这里面的石材做垒石，非常的生动。它的垒石和木头之间的搭配非常的有魅力。
Constructing this museum has been a personal journey for Hui.
一个好的建筑师要善于阅读你所在的场地和这个自然， 你在尊重自然的时候也是在尊重自己，你在发现自然的时候也是在发现你的自我。
Living harmoniously with nature. This is the ancient wisdom that the people of Guizhou firmly stand by.
大家有一种大局意识发展观，能够把我们苗族的历史文化和我们的青山绿水保护好，能够传承到我们的子孙后代。
现在很多城里面的人来找药，因为城市里面你找不着了呀，你只能到这些地方来，你才能够找得到，所以要保护我们现在的这个环境。
在这个过程中，你会发现你其实只是很小的自然中的一个微粒。
From food to clothing to healthcare to architecture and even big data, they are all gifts from nature. At a time when human development is often at odds with environmental protection, the people of Guizhou are using ancient wisdom to navigate their future and make theirs a province to watch.